you guys and girls, as you guys know, I like fish. Not to eat, but to look at. I've always been passionate about aquariums and things like that. I've had a betta, I've currently got two goldfish sitting in a tank right next to me, but I've always loved fish to look at. So I went looking on the internet for a fish tank simulator, and the best that I could find was Dream Aquarium. Now, Dream Aquarium basically focuses on the freshwater tropicals, not the saltwater tropicals, but it's actually one of the most accurate and pretty realistic looking fish tanks simulators I've actually seen. Now, what I mean by a simulator means it's actually a screensaver. So I can set this tank up as you see it here and leave it run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and just admire its beauty. The advantages are I don't need a 6-foot aquarium, I don't need to clean up the poop, and of course feeding them costs nothing. Now, I did pay for the full version, which is about $20 US. You get about, I think maybe 15 species with the full version, but I also purchased the additional fish packs, 1 and 2, which gives you, I can't remember how many more fish, but it gives you a few more species than what you get with the full version. So the full version is great, but it didn't have Bala sharks, which is what fish pack 1 actually offered. So I bought fish pack 1 and 2 because it was basically 10 bucks for the additional fish packs, and I thought, why not? Anyway, as this tank is set up to show you guys what the larger species of fish are, we've got a couple of dwarf gouramis in there, we've got silver moonies, we've got archer fish. Now, the archer fish don't actually squirt water out the top of the tank, but they do swim up to the top of the tank pretty regularly, and you get a pretty good idea of what those guys are going to be doing. You get, like for example, at the bottom of the tank, you can see a fiddler crab sitting there. Now, the fiddler crab actually interacts with the fish. If they get too close, he does make a grab at them with his claw. And the fish are like, whoa, hold it, I better not go near this bad guy. I've only ever seen him actually grab a fish once, and I think it was by accident. And the only thing that happened was the fish was stunned for 1 or 2 seconds and didn't move, and then swam off. So it was pretty weird. As you can see, as soon as the fish get close to his personal zone, he moves in to shoo them away. Now, as you can see, the fish actually interact with their environment pretty well. They swim behind the rock, in between the rocks, in between the plants. But as you guys see in a couple of seconds, this is not all the fish you get. This is my Bala shark tank setup. I've always wanted to keep Bala sharks, but never had the 6-foot aquarium necessary to keep them. So until I move into my next house, which will be somewhere in January, where I'll possibly look at getting a bigger tank, I'll have to put up with the digital version of Bala sharks. Now, Dream Aquarium is actually pretty accurate. The fish swim fast around the tank, they dart everywhere, they school together, they'll compete for the food. They just interact really well. I've got a blue fiddler crab at the back of the aquarium there, and once again he'll take a swipe at the fish if they get too close to him. But I've always loved Bala sharks, and now I have my own Bala shark tank. Let's move on to the next one. This is the small species tank I've got set up. Yes, it is overstocked, I'm well aware of it. The software actually has an option to prevent you from overstocking your tank, so it can be set up pretty realistically. As you can see, the fiddler crab is trying to grab at the fish, and you know, he's picking at the moss at the bottom of the tank. Here comes the food, so a feeding frenzy is about to begin. Yes, you can set the tanks up so the fish do poop, the poop does actually drop off and falls to the bottom of the tank, but at the moment, no one seems to be pooping. They're eating at the moment, so give them a while. It'll probably happen. But in this tank here, you've got cardinal tetras, killifish, swordtails, Dalmatian mollies, harlequin rasboras, I think I mentioned the killifish before, didn't I? Yeah, I did. You know, tiger barbs, you've got everything. Well, not everything, but you get a lot. But yeah, as you can see, the fish eyeballs move. They look where they're swimming. Sometimes their eyeballs will rotate. They'll look in a direction. They'll swim in that direction. They'll interact with the plants. They'll, you know, interact with the crab. You know, if the fish get too close, the crab will make a dart for them and try and grab them. But yeah, all in all, pretty realistic. Oh, fish is glitching into the stick right there. That's not normal, but it can happen. Now, you can have, I think, up to 6 different tanks. I'm hitting page up and page down to rotate between them. You can set it up to automatically rotate up to once every 30 minutes. You know, it's up to you. You can control how many fish you put in, what species of fish you put in. The works, you can move where the air bubbler is. You can move... The options are endless. You can control how much light goes into the tank. It's pretty cool. I'll just show you, for example. You know, you can set up to adjust the sound. You can allow overcrowding. You can disable that so it becomes realistic. You can set it up for a laptop to run when it's on battery. You can check for updates every 3 months, like I do with mine. You've got just a whole heap of options. Now remember, it is a screensaver, so if you want to set it up to be your actual screensaver when you're away from the computer, that's cool. But you can also set it up so it permanently runs. Which could make quite an interesting display for your shop. You know, you can always, you know, say for example you've got a doctor surgery and you don't want to have the risk of you know, contaminating water. You could set this up. Be actually pretty cool. Just run through the fish list for you. This is the full version plus the additional 2 fish packs. So all up, I think it's something like $30 US. You get a blue fiddler crab. You can only have 1 crab per tank. We've got the celestial pearl danios, the red tiger discus, the Bala sharks, the blue ramirez. I can't even pronounce that one, so I'm not going to bother. The silver moonies, the white cloud minnows, the rosy barbs, discus, jewel cichlid. Now the cichlids, as far as I know, don't grow, so that's a good thing. You got angel fish, you got the marble. Now you can customize the marble fish. You know, you can totally choose what one you'd like. Okay, you can then add it into the tank if you so desire. So that's the angelfish, the marble angelfish. We got the crimson spot rainbows. You got the Dalmatian mollies. You've got dwarf garamis, the black skirt tetras, harlequin rasboras, the archerfish. I can't even pronounce that one, so I'm not going to try. But here's that other fish you can customize, so you can, you know, make it as bright or as dull or as beautiful as you'd like. You know, then click the tail color and then just go crazy. Or you can hit the randomize and it will totally do it for you. But there you go, so you've got that. You've got that one there, I can't pronounce it. The Bosmani rainbow, the killifish, the swordtail, torpedo barb, Ramirez in the normal colour, the Congo tetra, Crebensis, chocolate gourami, the pearl gourami, the tiger barb, zebra danio, and of course the crab. So fiddler crab and the blue fiddler crab. So that's all, basically all the fish you can get. If you like fish as much as I do, it's probably your best bet. Ooh, I added a fish I don't want, so I can delete him. Okay, and hit the delete button. He's gone. Alrighty guys, until next time, I will say bye for now. Okay, see ya!